The tone, the time will be
7:30. Exactly.
Thank you, Mr. Cuckoo Clock. Thank you, boys and girls, for tuning in this morning. Thank you, Mr. Announcer Man, for introducing the program with a lot of enthusiasm. I was sound asleep, but was there a lot of enthusiasm this morning, Patches Pals? Well, that's good. We are going to have a lot of fun today. Today is Thursday, and it's February 15th, and that means... Already. Wow, this month has really flown by, hasn't it? Let's take a look and see if it's flown by. Wow, it really has flown by. Well, let's see, the first thing I'm going to... Oh, hi, Tykey Turkey. What are you doing here? Let's see. Yeah, just sit right there in my pocket there, Tykey Turkey. You can be nice and warm. First thing we're going to do, I'm going to tell you about... Oh, I have it right over here. You know, for the past few days, I've been telling you about the great View-Master sale they're having at some of the larger JCPenney stores. And I think everyone is familiar with the 3D pictures that you can get with View-Master. Chances are you probably have one of these, and if you don't, well, here's a great opportunity to get one at the larger JCPenney stores. You can see pictures in 3D. Now, we also have a talking View-Master over here. This talking View-Master, you can look, listen, laugh, and learn with it. And that is a lot of fun, and you'll really enjoy it. And the price, well, it's on special at the larger JCPenney stores for $12.99. By the way, this View-Master is $1.60. And then we also have a View-Master projector, and the price is $10.99. So for special bargains at all View-Masters, for all View-Masters, be sure and visit the larger JCPenney stores. Well, you know, the reason I'm enthused this morning is because the famous A-Ca-smella choir has been working for a couple of days to have a great song for good old Mr. Announcer Man out there. Yes, we have a song, Mr. Announcer Man. We'll get the radar ears and find out exactly what kind of a day it's going to be outside. I better look outside and see what kind of a day. What kind of a day? Oh, hi there, Grizz. What kind of a day is it? It rained a little bit yesterday. I bet it's going to be a beautiful day. It's always a beautiful day. Right. I think you're catching cold. You've been outside too long. Good morning, Mr. Announcer Man.
Mr. Announcer Man?
Yes, I was waiting for the gong to go away there, JP.
You're waiting
for
the
gong to
end.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
You have a song for me this morning?
Yes, I wrote it.
Oh, and moving along, friends.
Well, I had some help.
Well, are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Which would you prefer first, sir?
The weather.
The song, whatever?
The weather.
All right, the weather. About as yesterday, scattered showers are forecast for the northwest, considerable cloudiness, and a chance of rain by late tomorrow. High today, about 47 degrees. The rain chance is 30%. It will decrease to 20 by tonight, increase again to 50% by tomorrow.
Well, it might turn out to be a nice day.
It won't be too bad.
Do you have a poem for us this morning?
Well, I want to hear the song first.
Oh, no. This time we're going to be last.
Well, if you insist.
I insist.
Hey, you know, Monday's a holiday.
Monday? Oh, yes. George Washington's birthday.
That's right.
Yes.
So I thought.
Is it true that you met George Washington personally? Or is it true that you were on the other side to catch the dollar?
Don't pass the buck, J.P.
Okay.
All right. I thought perhaps we could, in observance of that. So Monday is a holiday, a day to rest or play. We'll be here to work for you so you can watch TV all day. The birthday of George Washington will always be the tops. George may be the father of his country, but Coca-Cola is the pop.
Yeah. Oh, hey. Very, very good. Okay, stop the music! We don't want that music in the background while the A-Ca-smella choir blends and meshes their voices for song for you this morning. Okay, let's go over to Group A over here. Group A is the leader here of the song. Are you ready, Group A? Very good. One, two, three. We get our weather from the man, Harold, Harold. We get our weather from the man, Harold is his name. Is it going to storm? Is it going to be bright? We get the weather from the man, Harold's out of sight.
You know, JP?
Yes.
That gives me a kind of a feeling way down inside.
Yeah, it does me too.
Sort of makes me sick is what it means.
Wow, did you hear that, A-Ca-smella choir? Well, deal with you later. Thank you very much, Mr. Announcer Man. Thank you, A-Ca-smella choir. Thank you, Clockety Bird. Hey, we are busy this morning. Hello, this is J.P. Patches.
Julius?
Yes, Gertrude.
Julius, I've got to talk to you right away, Julius.
What?
It's as simple as that. I just can't explain it. I've just got to come down and talk to you.
Something's happened.
Well, it certainly has, Julius, and I just can't tell you over the telephone.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, okay, hurry on down, Gertrude.
All right, here I go.
Bye. Wow, I wonder what's happened.
Hey, I'll bet Gertrude heard about Farrell's, the big tencennial.
So, do you know what? You know what's happening? Well, Farrell's is celebrating its 10th anniversary, and they are looking for a young lady, 10 years old, to be Farrell's Miss Tencennial. And it's, well, it would take me quite a while to tell you about it, but what you do is you stop in at Farrell's. If you are 10 years old, if you were born between September, or not, let's say if you were 10 between September 1972 and September 1973, so you're probably 10 right now, right? Okay, good. If you are 10 years old and you are a girl, why, stop in at any of the Farrells and find out about the big Tencennial celebration, and you can win all kinds of great prizes. You can be Miss Tencennial. How about that? We'll be telling you more about it, but in the meantime, stop in at Farrell's and get all the details. And by the way, there are four Farrells right in the western part of this area. There's one at 130th and Aurora, one at South Center, one at Bellevue Village, and don't forget, the newest Farrell's is up in Burnaby, B.C. at the Lougheed Mall. So, Farrell's is the place. Well, Gertrude's on her way down. We'll find out exactly what is wrong with Gertrude. I could have told her what was wrong with Gertrude while she was on the phone. But right now, let's take a look at our first cartoon in the morning. It's a Warner Brothers. Are you all set? Okay, let's activate our colorful Warner Brothers cartoon wheel. Here we go.
This is a glass. Oops! How many times has that happened at your house? Hi, this is a Cactus Kid. Taco Time has a real good deal for you. Go on into your participating Taco Time and buy a taco or any Taco Time food item at the regular price. Then, for only 40 cents more, you can get this big, colorful Taco Time glass filled to the brim with your favorite soft drink. You keep the glass. Start your collection at Taco Time today and tell them the Cactus Kid sent you.
Okay, Cactus Kid. Cactus Kid sent me, and I have started my collection of Taco Time glasses, and I hope you do the same thing because they really are neat, and they stack up like so. And you can make all the members of your family happy with Taco Time glasses, so stop in. Well, Gertrude is going to be here, and I just don't understand what her problem is this morning, Patches.
Julia!
Ooh, here she comes. Here she comes. Yes, come in, Gertrude.
Pardon me, will you just
come in, Gertrude.
Now is not the time to talk
about it. Don't mishandle those animals there,
I'm
Gertrude.
I'm not mishandling an animal. Julius, look at it.
Yes, that is it. That's your new dress.
Wait. Fred Ethel, just step back. One back to the cell. That's cool.
How are Fred and Ethel?
They're fine, Julius, but they've been bothering me.
I didn't even say...
I'm happy you didn't.
Yeah.
Really, I am. Julius, I gotta tell you, look at my dress.
Yes, and that's your new dress. Let's have a nice hand for
your
seamstress.
I did not come down here for compliments, Julius. My new dress is disappearing.
Disappearing?
Yeah, spots all over, just disappears. No. Look, when I say three, it'll disappear. I'll go one, two, three, and it'll disappear. All set?
Okay.
One, two, three, look at it.
Nothing's happened. I don't see anything.
It's the funniest thing in the world. Julius has just been blotching out and all over. And the only person I knew that could help me would be
you. Hey, I want to go outside and say hi to Fred and Ethel. I didn't get a chance to say hi.
Okay, go ahead and say hi to Fred and Ethel. It'll happen. Julius! Come here! That turns different colors! Julius, it's here!
What?
Come in here! What? See? Did you see it?
See what?
Now, you interrupted me when I was talking to Fred and Ethel.
Hey, Fred!
No! Judas, come back in here! Quick, come back in here! See?
What?
Colors, Judas. I know it. And really, I don't feel bad at all. I understand, Judas. Colors. Really, it changed colors.
Maybe it did. I'll get to you later. Right now, I want to tell the Patches pals about a great Walt Disney motion picture that's coming to town. Take a look.
Hey, the one we've been talking about?
What's right? going on down there? This is incredible.
The world's losingest coach and his no-help assistant go to Africa and find a one-man athletic team in Walt Disney Productions' movie comedy, The World's Greatest Athletes.
You better get going.
At the Snow King Drive-In and the Valley Drive-In. It's going to be a great movie.
And it's also at the Crossroads in Bellevue and the Cinema One in Renton and the Bay in Ballard. And as Gertrude said, the Snow King and Valley Drive-In.
Huh?
Drive-In.
But you're good at that early in the morning, you know?
Well, you know,
go back outside, Judas. It seems to happen every time you go outside.
Wait. What? You know, I kind of believe you. I'll tell you what. I'll go outside and sneak around the back window back there.
Good idea.
And you, when you say JP...
Yeah, good.
Hook my head through the back window back there.
When it happens, I'll scream JP, okay?
All right.
Good. Go ahead. JP! JP! Julius! Look at it! See? Didn't work that time at all.
Go ahead. Go back out.
Okay, we'll try it again.
Good idea.
La, 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 la. Julius, look now, look now! Julius, it doesn't
work. Wait, I've got a good idea. I'm coming right back.
It doesn't work, Julius. And what? There it is, Julius! Look right now! Look at the house!
Here I come.
Listen, Gertrude, I've got a plan, but first of all, let's take a look at our next cartoon. It's right here in my cartoon hat. Here we go.
If you live in any of the areas listed on your screen, you may be able to receive a better picture from Channel 7 Seattle by tuning the UHF channel listed for your locality. For more information, call MA47087.
They all laughed when I sat down to play the piano with Shakey's. Oh, is that our pizza?
I asked the banjo player at Shakey's if he knew how to bake a pepperoni pizza. He said no, but if you hum a few bars, I'll fake it.
Ready? I think that Shakey's has the best tasting pizza in the world. So why do they need all that piano playing music and stuff?
That's what you missed at Shakey's yesterday. You should have been there.
Hey, you know what, Gertrude? I went to Shakey's last night out in Linwood, and I had some great pizza, and there are 19 other Shakey's in Western Washington.
Judas, they're just all over. Anybody can find a great Shakey's to jump into and have the time of their life, because Shakey's also pizza.
I had a Shakey's special.
A Shakey's special?
Yes, it has pepperoni, and it has sausage, and it has onions, and it has mushrooms.
Oh, I'm sort of favored to a Big Ed special, but actually the Shakey's special. Julius, what are we talking
about?
My dress is disappearing, and it's gone. And it's coming up with all sorts of different colors and stuff.
Listen, I've been going out that door, right?
Yeah, right.
I'm going to go down in the Gore's secret room. I've got the door open.
Good idea.
And instead of calling me, can you whistle?
Certainly I can whistle.
Let me see you whistle. Here you go. Yeah, no. Well, let's see. Good. When you whistle, I'll come out and I'll see what's happening to your dress. Yeah, not now.
Oh, good.
Well, Gertrude, I think I'll go down and see how Gorse the friendly purple is in the secret room, okay?
You take care of yourself and check out with Gorse. Yeah. Good.
How's your bed, Gorse? Hey, that's pretty good, Gorse. Yes, I know.
Julius! What? You ding-dong!
Yes, what, Gertrude?
I whistled 46 times. You came back and it stopped.
Oh, you know, well, Gorse was talking so loud,
Hey.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm going down in the secret room
again,
Gertrude.
You check out with Gorse, and I'll see you later. I'm leaving.
Okay, bye-bye.
Okay.
Listen, Gorse, stop swinging.
Julius! Julius, come out here! Julius, it's going to be right down! You go right back down there and you stay with Gorse, because right now we're going to see one of the greatest cartoons you've ever seen in your life.
We're not going to?
Cool. All right. Zabba, 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 zoo. Secret room. Secret room. Hey, you know, I kind of like it when you're down there. You know that?
Nothing wrong.
Zabba, 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 zoo, secret room, Alakon, zoo. That must have unleashed them.
Thanks, Gorth.
Okay. See, Julius?
Listen, Gertrude.
While you're down there playing your little menial games and doing all of that silly business, my dress is changing colors, and it's magic, it's magic, it's magic, it's magic.
Listen, I know what I'm going to do.
What?
I'm going to call the Swami Pastrami up and tell him exactly what's happened.
Well, it's about time you finally got some idea, Julius, okay. Because I'm leaving right now, and I am not coming back down to this house, because if ever I come in here, my dress changes
yes,
color.
Well, even though I didn't see it, I know you always tell the truth.
Julius, I'm not lying at all. I'm telling
okay.
you the truth.
Very good. We'll see you later, Gertrude.
Okay, see you later.
Bye-bye.
Take care of yourself.
Well, boys and girls, maybe the Swami will know what's happening to Gertrude's dress, eh? Right. Let's check the old clock on the wall. Hey, I see it's just about 30 seconds past 8 o'clock. And if you weren't around in the earlier part of the show, remember that the JCPenney stores, the larger stores, are having a ViewMaster sale. And I want to tell you about three of the ViewMasters. Here's the old favorite here. Chances are you might have one. But if you don't, well, they're on special at the larger JCPenney stores for $1.60. The Talking ViewMaster, believe it or not, you can actually hear a talk. You can look, listen, laugh, and learn with a Talking ViewMaster. And you can get it at the larger JCPenney stores for $12.99. And how about a projector? Here's an entertainment projector ViewMaster. And you can get it at the larger JCPenney stores for $10.99. So be sure and visit JCPenney, okay? Well, I'll be calling the Swami of Pastrami up, but right now... But right now, I think that's Mrs. Olson again. Okay.
JP, what? JP Patches.
Mr. Slick!
No, JP, I'm not Mr. Slick.
Oh, you're not?
No, JP, I am Ralph Lumptious.
Ralph Lumptious.
JP, entertainer of millions, friend of children, for two generations, or is it three now?
Three
generations. JP, in honor of the fact that you've been such a wonderful person for 15 years, today, JP, on the JP Patches program, JP Patches, this is your life, JP.
Wow.
In honor of this beautiful day, 15 years with J.P. Patches in the Great Northwest, we thought it would be time to reminisce, J.P. And J.P., do you remember way back when this young man first came upon the scene in the Northwest? Can you tell us about that, J.P.?
Yes, that was about 40 pounds ago. 40 pounds.
Who is that young man? Do you recognize him, J.P.?
No, I don't.
You don't recognize him?
I visited one of the fine bakeries in town that is no longer
Whatever
there.
Happened to that bakery, J.P.? Ah, yes. Well, J.P., here you are, a young man. I noticed a tricycle there. It looks a little different now, doesn't it,
well,
J.P.?
Well, we still have that trike. I think the 40 pounds did it in.
All things change with time, J.P., isn't
yes,
that
Yes, Ralph, you are so right.
And here we are, J.P., right here in the very same house in the city dump. Who is that young man?
Well, that was about 20 pounds ago.
20 pounds ago.
Funny, you notice how fast I moved in those days.
You certainly did, J.P. Well, J.P., moving right along, as they say on TV.
Well, Ralph Unctious, this is quite...
Moving right along, J.P., once again, this is your life, and we thought perhaps you'd enjoy reminiscing with some famous names and voices from the past. J.P., as you can see, right here in this little blue square, there he is, J.P.
Herodocus, Mucho Crocus, I'm happy as can be.
Who is that?
You'll be here at
I don't know. Don't you know who that is?
My friend, J.P.
Well, it's old Stan Boreson.
Success to you galore. And know
is
that
he
you'll
here?
Be on the tube forevermore. J.P., it's a pleasure to be here this morning, and I want to tell you that the 15 years have gone by real fast. And we're looking forward to having you on for 40 or 50 more. All the best on your 15th anniversary.
Wasn't that wonderful, J.P.?
Well, I think...
Stan Boreson.
Stan is one
Stan
of my favorites.
Stan is here this morning to see you, and a little later on, he'll be coming in as we have a little party after we meet all of these wonderful names and voices from the past. I think it's about time for another one right now, J.P. Who do we have here?
Captain Puget!
Captain Puget.
Ahoy, matey. I just wanted to reminisce a little bit. I think the first time I ever met our good friend J.P., he was so poor he didn't have two park benches to rub together. He was just a tramp. It's a fact. And now look at him. He owns his own city dump. And it's pretty hard to beat an arrangement like that. 15 years. It's amazing. I hope you have at least 15 or 20 more. And congratulations and the best of luck to you on your 15th.
Well, thank you, Captain, very much. Your old friend, Captain Puget.
Well, you know,
wonder what ever happened to him, J.P.?
Well, he's the star of Northwest Traveler.
He certainly is. He's a wonderful fellow.
Exploration Northwest,
right. On Channel 4 here in Seattle. Finally went straight. Well, I wonder who else we have here. Let's take a look back into the memories of time, J.P. Why? Who is that man?
Could it... Well, there is an animal man.
Oh, there he is out there. J.P., how are you? It's been so long. You remember when I left and those long years ago and I took off to go to the deep, darkest part of Africa and find the world's biggest tiger and bring him back to you. J.P., I left. I don't know what happened, you know. My compass never worked and I got lost again. And I've been searching all this time for you. It's taken nearly 15 years. But while I was gone, J.P., I didn't find the tiger, but I brought back the world's champion alligator. And I brought it to you. That alligator loves to wrestle, J.P., and if you'll take that alligator out and wrestle with him twice a day, you're going to have great fun with him. He's right outside your door. You build a little moat out there, and he'll swim around and keep you company. I know it's going to be good fun for you, J.P., and he'll be there every day for you. Good to be back with you, and I'll see you later on.
Uncle Jack, the animal man.
A real Uncle Jack, the animal man.
Wow, I sometimes wonder about his assistant, though.
I do, too. J.P., we'd better not go outside because that alligator...
That alligator, yes. He said a lot of, you know, just once swimming in the moat.
Just once. It only takes one time. J.P., I wonder who else we can bring back through the mists of time this morning. Hark, what is that?
J.P., you look a little corpulent, man.
Why, it's old BeeBop Buzzard!
Yeah, I couldn't make it in person, baby. You know, I had my threads out for the cleaner, so I'm just kind of hanging around there in my underfeathers. So I just thought I'd stop by and whiz one on you.
Why, BeeBop sounds a little older.
Certainly does.
Hey, you notice that crackle in his voice?
Crackling gray in the voice.
Older, baby! You know, you're the one that looks a little corpulent, like heavy. I'll dig you 15 from now.
Well, BeeBop, thank you very much for dropping in with us today.
He was one of my favorites.
He certainly was. One of all of our favorites.
He introduced me to our Topocketty Bird.
That's true. Mm-hmm. In fact, the Topocketty Bird is the stand-in for BeeBop
Buzzard. For BeeBop Buzzard.
Right, yes.
Well, and Ralph, this is...
Standing in a long time.
I'm really thrilled.
Are you really thrilled?
Yes.
I can tell by the look on your face that you're really thrilled, J.P. Let's see who else we can ring in here through the magic of electronic wizardry. Pardon me, sir, I don't recognize you. What are you doing here?
Well, I'm a TV actor, and my specialty is doing bit parts on children's shows.
Oh, really?
Get rid of him!
What is it that you came in here to do?
Well, I was outside there walking down the street, and this fellow came along and said that he had a part for someone in here, just a one-liner, but, you know, how things are, man has to have bread.
What did the fellow say the one line was? What was the bit?
Well, he said, when you hear the cannons go off, he says, you just got this one line. All I have to say is... What was that?
Do you understand that, J.P.?
Well, no, but I recognize that. Who
was that man?
That's Fran Geidis.
That's right. Fran Geidis used to work here a long time ago.
Didn't they all?
Yes, they did, J.P. Uh-huh. I wonder who else we can ring in here, moving right along. Let's see.
Oh, hold that, J.P.! This is Wilfred! Remember me? I used to pick up your garbage!
Boy, Wilfred, the garbage man!
Because you know what? I'm a sanitary engineer now, and I'm working with the mayor! Yeah, that's right! We got problems, J.P.! We don't know where to give our garbage, so I send it down to the coma, but they don't want it, J.P.! So I sent it up to Muckle Deal, and the ecologist guy said you can't do that. So the mayor says, hey, Captain Will, that's what they call me now, not a colonel, you know. And I said, well, we got a saying in the garbage business, JP.
We what is it, Wilfred?
We smell them. And he says, where are we going to sell the garbage? I said, I got an idea. Let's make it all into big logs and send it to Japan. But I got a problem, JP. I don't know what to do with it, so I want to come down and talk to you about it, okay?
Okay, Wilfred.
Thanks, well, Wilfred, very much for stopping
well,
in.
How long is this program?
I think we're out of time, as the clock on the wall says. Moving right along, JP, it was wonderful to see your old friend,
well,
Wilfred
Ralph,
the Garbage Man.
Well,
let's see who else we can ring in here for you, the JP, this morning.
Why, it's old Sheriff Shot Badley.
Where are you, Chester? Where are you? Listen, Chester. Oh, there you are. Listen, you want to see my fast draw, Chester? Huh? You want to see that?
He was famous for this.
You ready?
Uh-huh.
Okay, here it comes. No, I can't do it quite as fast. Did you want to see it again?
Yeah, you're slowing down. It was a little slower than it used to be.
Well, you know, I'm not as young as I used to be, Chester. But I want to say it's a pleasure to see you here today. In another 15 years, I'll be back and see you again now, you hear?
Okay, thank you. Wow, what a sheriff.
Wonder what ever happened to him.
Well, he's, you
rode
know...
rode off into the sunset.
He hung his guns up.
He hung his guns
yes,
up.
Yes, he yeah. did.
And rode off into the sunset.
Old Sheriff Shot Badley.
Sir, let's see who else we have here for you this morning, J.P. Why, that's a strange-looking man.
Why, it's
the real
Wizard of Gizzard!
Oh, that's right, J.P. I thought you might forget. You know, I've sort of gone out of the wizard business. Doggone Auburn had to recall my magic wand. It got into reverse and I couldn't change the transmission back into forward. Oh, it's just terrible. But congratulations on 15 years.
Thank you, Wizard. Are you ever coming back? I mean, we're having problems with the Swami of Pastrami.
Problems with my hat. My head's a little bit smaller than it used to be.
Thank you, oh great Wizard.
A little hard to see the Wizard's eyes there this morning,
yes,
JP.
Not
much eye contact. Well, J.P., there's been many famous names and voices from the past, and let's take a look again and see who else we can ring in here.
Left, Seagulls, quit moving forward or backward or sideways, but keep moving your little footsies up and down in the mud there. We're going to surprise J.P. this morning. It's his anniversary. He's going off of probation. They're going to put him on full time, I understand. All right,
why, it's a famous Professor Wiener von Braun.
Did he? That's J.P., that's the guy. Hi, J.P., how is you?
Professor, what have you been up to?
What have I... About 5'6" most of the time, except when I stand in a hole, which I do an awful lot lately. I don't know about that. I'm at a big conference. It's OSC, the Out of Sight Conference, and I'm teaching them all about the Earth, you know, how they've got the funny globes, they're all round, and they just don't understand. They come to me, and they say, Professor, I say, Jazz. They say, what makes you think the world is flat? And I say, well, look at the floor. Is the floor round? No, the floor is flat. So that means the Earth is flat. And I say, my name is Professor Wienner von Braun. Oh, that is not true. I'll see you a little bit later, JP. We're running a little long.
Say,
bye.
Professor, bye. One more thing, Professor. Where did you get that hat?
Where did you get that hat? Oh, you weren't supposed to see that.
Wow, I wonder whatever happened to his famous Ben-O-Matic.
I don't know, JP.
Wow, that was quite a machine.
He's marched off into the eternity of time, and he's out there somewhere doing professor things.
Well,
isn't
that's
that wonderful?
Terrific.
He might even be in the academic life now.
Well,
perhaps.
He was a very smart man.
He was. I wonder if there's anyone else that we could bring in to see you this morning, JP. Why, who is that?
Where he went. If I could just get me mitts on him, I'd do a job on him.
It's
like
the infamous I Am Rags!
Hey, is that your voice I'm hearing, clown?
It's I am Rags. What are you doing here?
I come down with. I just saw some other people here forming a great big crowd, and I thought I'd just drop in, maybe pick a few pockets, you know, beat somebody up or something. Made me feel so good about that. I thought that maybe I'd come down and maltreat you a little bit, just like old times.
Well, I'm kind of busy talking to my friends. I am. I won't have time to see. Why don't you go and look up Boris S. Wart? I think you two are quite a bit alike.
What, he's the second meanest, and I'm waking at it. I think that I'll come down and I'm gonna fix you up, JP. Fix you up the door, give you a little fresh air. Just, you know, really, just like old times. Yeah. See you in a bit.
Ralph, would you stick around if I am Rank shows up?
I'll protect you from him, JP. Well, JP, those are some of the friends that we brought here to see you this morning on This Is Your Life, JP Patches, 15 years of celebration, and we thought you'd enjoy seeing these old names and faces from the past. And in just a moment, they're all going to come in here. We're going to have a reunion. We're going to have a nice cake and maybe some milk and some...
Do I have to pay for it?
No, JP. It's all taken. There's one person, however, that we tried to get here this morning but just couldn't make it in. We thought it would be wonderful, call down to Wrinkle City, call Grandma Patches, but there was a problem. She wouldn't work for scale. Couldn't get her to come in here this morning.
Grandma Patches,
Grandma Patches.
Well...
She's down there in Wrinkle City, California. We have all of our friends coming in, and this morning, Myron Storer from the Fantastic Cake Box, JP, in honor of this occasion, rather than a charm bracelet, we have for you a beautiful cake. Here it is, JP. Isn't that pretty?
Myron. Wow.
It says, congratulations, JP, 15 years on KIRO-TV Channel 7. And over there it says, everybody is JP's pal.
Well, that's... I'm speechless.
Are you really?
For the first time. And
well, we thought you would enjoy it, JP.
Oh, JP, how are you? It's good to see you.
That's changed a bit, that's exactly right.
Happy anniversary, you know, that stuff.
Hi, Frank.
Hello there, oh great wizard.
Hello there, Jay. How are you?
Hello there, Professor.
Hi, I couldn't figure out which was the cake and which was you. Good to see you again.
Hi, that's the Earth.
Oh, that's the Earth.
It's Quirky, Sam.
Congratulations.
Well, thank you, Captain.
Sam, nice stand by to roll a cartoon.
Okay, JP. Hello there, Mr. Bird.
Good to see you up in the
JP. Uncle
Jack.
How are you? Chester.
Howdy, Sheriff.
Hi.
I am? Now what happens, Rob?
Now what happens, JP, is that in honor of this occasion, and we're all here and we're going to talk and have a little piece of cake, and while we do that, the children at home are going to watch a cartoon.
You're kidding.
No, I'm not.
Wow.
Here it is, right inside.
Oh, no, wait. You got a cartoon in there?
Right in there, JP.
Wow.
It's right here in the third dot in my tie.
Let's count up. One, two, three. Well, my friends are still here, and, you know, we have three people here who had... children's programs, and they are going to do the J.C. Penney commercial, and they're going to be talking about each of the Viewmasters, and we'll start off with Stan. Stan, you want to show them the Viewmaster projector and tell them about it. Wow. Confucius A, picture is worth 1,000 words, and it's on special for $10.99 at the larger J.C. Penney stores, and... Is that what we're going
right
to get
now?
From you?
Okay. No, you'll get something different from me. The new
Could
Viewmaster
be the
dimension
of a new
is
career.
It says is popular everywhere. They can see their favorite cartoon characters and famous travel shows like Exploration Northwest.
See, you tilt it down.
And, you walked on
it
my line.
It shines on it as
we are.
Tilt it down, Don.
Tilt it down. That's fair enough.
Okay.
Only $12.99.
Make it look like you're not
available.
Reading the copy, too.
You know, it's just like being back with the idiot four men I used to work with. We've got him.
We've got him here.
I heard that.
So did I.
Sheriff shot Badley.
Lot number 2015, item 4.
Well, that's good. They should ask for lot number what?
2015.
Okay. That's on special.
Wait a minute, that's 1520, I think it is.
That's a lot.
Do you dumb thing, Bet? Why don't you get some glasses?
Okay. Well, that was... Anyway, they're available at the larger JCPenney stores. Well, you know, 15 years ago, I started the JP Patches program, and And there was Stan on the air, and Captain Puget, and Brakeman Bill, and a few other people. And Brakeman Bill is still here, and I'm still here. And, of course, Stan is a busy person. I wonder who is the smart one. That's what I'm trying to say. Stan, of course, will soon be opening a restaurant, Pier 70.
That's right.
And Captain Puget has his own TV show, and he's traveling all over the Northwest. And Uncle Jack, the Animal Man, is at Channel 9. And Professor is teaching in Highline School District. And BeeBop Buzzard is...
Where is he?
Where is BeeBop Buzzard down? Evergreen...
Evergreen State College.
And Fran, Geidis is Channel 5. And Ralph. And, well, anyway, I could go on and on. And I'd like to thank everyone who participated in this real nice surprise. And I'd like to thank you boys and girls for watching me for 15 years. And even a lot of moms and dads watch too. And we've got a minute, and I don't know what to do.
I know what to do. For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow. Which nobody can deny. Which nobody can deny. Which nobody can deny. For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow.
Thank you very, very much. Thank you. Okay, thank you.
Congratulations.
And you were a little flat there.
As usual.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, Ralph.
It's all right, JP.
Thank you.
You're
welcome.
Thank you.
In my gloves.
Yeah!
I got the script down there.
The glove lady's been slipping lately.
Never forget the time.